Welcome students. Today we will be starting with another topic in this chapter, that is motion curves. Now what is this motion curves? It is in the simple form, it is just a graphical representation of displacement, velocity and acceleration with respect to time. So simply I can say motion curves are nothing but the graphical representation of displacement. I can say it is a x. Some books also give it as s. So it is a graphical representation of displacement, velocity and acceleration with respect to time. Before proceeding further to the problem side, let us first understand the basics behind this. Now let us consider a particle given by the displacement equation x is equal to 2t cube plus 5t square minus 6t. This is the expression about which the particle is being displaced. Now if we want velocity of this particle, we all know that if we take the derivative of displacement with respect to time, then we get the velocity. So if I take the derivative of this, I will get 6t square plus 10t minus 6. This is nothing but the expression for velocity for that particle. Now this becomes my displacement, this becomes my velocity expression. Now for acceleration, we know that it is the derivative or the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So if I want rate of change of velocity with respect to time, I will differentiate this particular equation. So I will get 12t plus 10. Now please understand this. This is a very basic and important thing for understanding the concept of motion curves. Now as we said, the motion curves are graphical representation of displacement, velocity and acceleration with respect to time. Now so if I want to draw a graph of displacement with respect to time, I will do it like this. Let us say this is displacement x and this is time t. Now if you observe this entire equation, the highest power or highest degree is 3. That means it is following a cubical pattern. So I will draw a curve here. So I will draw a cubical curve here and I will write here it is a cubic curve. Similarly, if I want to draw velocity time graph, I will plot here velocity versus time. Now in velocity versus time, the highest degree is 2. If highest degree is 2, that means it is nothing but a parabolic curve. So I will make a curve and denote it that it is a parabola. Similarly, if I want to draw acceleration curve, acceleration with respect to time graph, I will make here t, I will make here a, and this is nothing but acceleration versus time graph. Now if you observe the equation of acceleration given, the highest degree of time is 1. That means it is a linear equation. So for linear equation, I will draw one linear line. So this three curves of displacement, velocity and acceleration with respect to time are known as motion curves. Now one thing that is worth noting here, if you see that when we go from displacement to velocity and velocity to acceleration, the degree of the curves goes on decreasing. For example, the degree of the curve here was 3, the degree of the curve in velocity was 2, and the degree in acceleration is 1. That means as we go down from displacement towards acceleration side, the degree of the curve decreases. Similarly, on the other hand, let us say I am given the velocity expression. Let us say here v is equal to, let us say 6t plus 2, and if I draw the velocity time diagram, it will be like this. Let us say this is velocity and this is time diagram, and as the highest degree is 1 here, it will be a linear number. Now, as per the concept, if I want the acceleration graph, so I am coming downside of velocity, and now we have seen that if we go towards acceleration, the degree decreases. So if the degree here is 1, the degree here should be 0. So I will make a constant line having a degree 0. So this becomes my acceleration time graph for this particular case, wherein the velocity is linear. Now we have drawn velocity time graph, we have drawn acceleration time graph. Now for the same case, let us say I want to draw a xt curve. Now if I want to draw xt curve, I am going above velocity. So if I am going above velocity, the degree will increase. So here it is 0 degree, here it is 1 degree. So here it should be a second degree curve, that means it should be a parabola. So I will make a parabola here. So this will become my xt graph. Now let us look at the same thing by the equations. The equation given to us was v is equal to 6t plus 2. Now if I want acceleration, I will write a is equal to dv by dt, because we know that the rate of change of velocity with respect to time gives me acceleration. So if I take the derivative, I will get 6. So as there is no t term present here, that means it is not dependent on time, that means it is a constant. And same graph we have got here, that it is a constant line. Now let us say I want the expression for x or displacement. We know that velocity is rate of change of displacement with respect to time. In other words, I can say, or x is nothing but integration of velocity with respect to time, because we have the basics of integration. If v is equal to d by dx of t, then I can write integration x is equal to integration of d by dt. So taking integration of this particular equation, I will get 6 t square by 2 plus 2t. So now you can see here the highest degree is 2. That means it should be a parabolic curve. So we have drawn here also a parabolic curve. So in simple terms, what you have to remember, when you go, if I write it in the sequence x, v, a, wherein x is displacement, v is velocity, and a is acceleration. When we go towards downside, the degree of the curve decreases. Wherein if we go on the top side, from acceleration to displacement, the degree of curve increases. One more thing which I want to show you is, again observe the equations. From x, if we wanted v, what we did the derivative. So if, now again the second point worth noting here is, if we go from top to bottom in the sequence of displacement, velocity and acceleration, we always need to find out the rate of change, that means derivative, or in other terms I can write it as a slope. So I can say that the slope of xt curve gives me velocity curve, and the slope of velocity gives me acceleration. Slope means what? Rate of change of something. So if I take rate of change of displacement, I will get velocity. If I take rate of change of velocity, I will get acceleration. This is what, when we go in this sequence, from displacement to velocity to acceleration. But suppose there is some case wherein acceleration is given to us and we need to find out velocity and displacement. For that cases, we need to take the integration. Integration, or we can say it should be area under the curve. So to summarize, when we go in the descending order from displacement to velocity to acceleration, we need to find out the slope of the curve, and the degree of the curve decreases. wherein if we go in the ascending order from acceleration to displacement, the degree of curve increases and we need to take the integration or the area under the curve. So hope you have understood this concept. This was the very important concept or logic behind the motion curve. Now let us study some examples. Now let us say in the question, it is given to us as this is your VT curve, for example. And you are expected to find what will be the nature of displacement time curve and what should be the acceleration curve. Now here we have seen that if we go from displacement to velocity and then to acceleration, the degree decreases. Wherein if we go towards upside, the degree increases. Now what we are given? We are given that this is the VT curve. So if this is a VT curve, I am here at this particular point, at V. Now if I want to find out acceleration curve, I am going downward. So if I am going downward, the degree should decrease. The here the degree of the curve is 1, single degree. So when we go to find out the acceleration curve, the degree should decrease or the degree should be 0, which is in this curve. So I will name this as AT curve for this particular case. Now from V, I need to go towards X, that is displacement. So we know that when we go upside, the degree increases. So if here the degree is 1, the degree will be 2 here for XT curve. So this will become my XT curve for this particular case. Now let us say, again for the same example, let us say in question we are given that this is the thing but my AT curve, for example. Now if this is AT curve, now we are at this particular point. From A, I want to find out V. That means the degree should increase. Here it is a zero curve, there is no acceleration. So if there is a zero acceleration, the next, that means velocity time graph, should be a 0 degree curve because acceleration is zero. Now I reach here at velocity point. From velocity, I need to go to displacement. So here the degree is zero. So for zero, the degree should be 1. So this will become now my XT curve for this particular case wherein acceleration was 0. Okay, let us say another example. Let us say that now it is given that this particular curve, which is given here, is an AT curve. This particular curve is an AT curve, and we are required to find out what is VT curve and what is XT curve. So if this is AT curve with a degree 1 and we are going towards VT, so from A to V, the degree goes on increasing. So this will become, this curve or this diagram will become my VT curve, because here also the degree has been increased from 1 to 2. Now from V, I want to go to displacement. That means again I am going towards upside, that means degree will be increased. So this particular nature of the curve will be nothing but my XT curve. So hope you have understood the logic of drawing XT, VT and AT curves. The same replica is towards the left side. So here let us say this is AT curve. So this will become my VT and this will become my XT. Or if this is my VT curve, this will become my XT curve and this will be my AT curve. Similarly, let us say in the question it is given that this is your AT curve. This particular curve is your AT curve. So this will become your VT curve and this will become your XT curve. Now, what is the difference between these two columns? Just one difference is here is the acceleration, the velocity here was in the increasing direction. It is going continuously increasing with respect to time. Whereas in this particular case, the velocity or the parameters goes on decreasing with respect to time. Okay? So in this case, when it is decreasing, the parabola will be like this and the cubic curve will be like this towards downside. and wherein the velocity or the parameters go on increasing with respect to time, the parabolic curve will also go on increasing like this, and the cubic curve will also go on increasing like this. So this was all about the concepts and logic of motion curves. So hope now it is clear to you all. From the next class onwards, we will start with solving the problems based on these concepts.